talk about masks. Now, when you hear somebody say, hey, you gotta wear a paint mask, really, it's not a mask. If you're wearing one of those little paper things over your face, that is called a mask, and that's simply for dust, basically, and that's why they're called a dust mask. When you're dealing with paint or any chemical for that matter, you need to be wearing what is called a respirator. A respirator goes a little bit further in the level of protection for when you're dealing with chemicals and paint especially. So I'm going to show you a few really quick tips to make sure that you get the right respirator and it works correctly to keep you safe. The first thing you want to look for when you go get a respirator is to see what it's actually designed for. So the easiest thing is I look for, because 3M is such a big company, I always know I can find their respirators pretty much anywhere. When I go down to the hardware store, I look for a 3M mask first. Then I look for, hey, what is it actually made for? And this one specifically says paint project respirator. So that helps put me in the right direction. Now, you might see a few that say that, and then the next thing you're going to notice is that there's very minor differences, and actually most of the differences you can't notice, but you kind of need to know what to look for. Usually you'll see a difference in about $10. A mask, a respirator, usually starts around $20 and goes up to anywhere from like $35 to $40. Really, usually the difference is the cartridges are usually the same, but they usually have what are called pre-filters on them. Now, this mask actually came with pre-filters, but I wanted to show you what it looks like without pre-filters on, because this is what you're most likely going to see when you go to the hardware store. This mask has simply the cartridges. And is this safe to use? Absolutely, no problem. All a pre-filter is a piece that goes on the outside of this piece and actually works like a dust mask, like I talked about before. But it works like a dust mask on top of the actual filter, so it keeps most of the particulates out of the filter, and the filter can really just deal specifically with the chemical vapors. Now, what it really does is when you have a pre-filter, your mask will last longer because it doesn't get all gummed up with particulates, and you can change out the pre-filters. The next thing you want to look for is the size. Most of, you know, the respirators from 3M simply have the size right on the front, and it actually will have a little letter here. It'll either say S, M, or L. And I'll show you in just a second, make sure you that it fits correctly. But for most people, a medium is going to work. If you're a really big dude, maybe a large, but for the most part, medium and large, it's not going to make a huge
difference. Take this respirator out of the box, and let me show you what the actual pre-filters look like.
So a lot of times the cartridges themselves will come sealed in a plastic bag or something like that. It has to do with what's actually in these filters. They last longer if they're sealed in an airtight container. So that's why they usually come separated and you just put them on. And they usually just twist on or whatever, and it's pretty simple. Next are these little things. And these are the pre-filters that I was talking about. These are literally like those little paper masks that you wear for sawdust and things like that. But what they do is they sit inside this little plastic piece, and then they sit on top of the vapor filters themselves. So, and these just snap on. So just like I said, you want to get a mask that or a respirator that has these little pre-filters on it, really for the main reason is because they'll last longer and you don't have to continuously change out these filters. Every time you change out your filters, you don't need to buy a new mask. But you know, at $20, usually by the time that you go through one of these filters, your mask will be falling apart. But it just depends. The filters are definitely a little bit cheaper. They're about $10 as opposed to buying a whole new mask for $20 or $30.
Next, let's talk about the fit of your respirator on your face. This is actually a trick I learned in the military, but all you really have to do to make sure that you have a good seal, and that's all you're really trying to do is get a good seal around this mouthpiece, is to cover up the intakes, suck in a little bit, and you should feel a little bit of a suction pressure on your face. Now, these pre-filters aren't airtight, so when you put your hand over them, a little bit of air seeps through, so it's not going to suck completely against your face, but you'll feel a little bit of suction. And as long as you feel a little bit of suction, it means that you have a good seal and that mask fits. So when you see, when I put my hand on the respirator and I suck in, I can feel the mask suck into my face just a little bit. That's how I know I have a good seal around here and this mask fits and is working properly. Talked about the fit of your mask and how you can basically tell if it's fitting correctly. Now, the next way to always know if your mask is actually working is while you're working with paint, you shouldn't smell the paint at all. Now, me being in the military, the way you can tell your mask isn't working in the gas chamber is if you smell tear gas and your eyes start to water up and you feel like you're going to suffocate and die. But if that happens while you're painting, then you're painting with the wrong stuff and you're definitely doing something wrong. But remember, you shouldn't smell any vapors when you're using a respirator. So if you do, it means something is not fitting correctly or your filters aren't on all the way and you need to stop and fix it. So those are the basics when it comes to using a paint respirator, and you always need to be using one of these, believe it or not. Because when you're painting, the chemicals in paint are not going to affect you right now. They might make you feel dizzy or a little bit sick, but the real problems come years later, and professional painters always have problems years later that snuck up on them because they weren't wearing a mask their whole careers. So don't play around with paint, seriously. It is pretty stinking dangerous stuff. And even if you've got a mask on, you should still well ventilate the area. That takes the workload off your mask. It'll not only last longer, but you still run a better chance of not inhaling fumes that might slip through the filters a little bit. Even the professionals, when they paint in a paint booth, the reason they're painting in a booth is actually to cut down on dust. Those booths are still ventilated usually, and they are sucking and pushing fresh air into them, but they have a bunch of filters on them to try to cut down on dust, but they usually are still ventilated. So even those guys inside of a booth are still trying to ventilate the vapors out of the booth. If you've got any questions, post them in the comments, and of course, don't forget to subscribe. I'm Tony D.